What's up, guys? Welcome to another update video. I can't wait to see how many of you comment about the fact that I have my evil goatee going on. We're just going to talk today about some of the stuff that's been going on with just life in general for me, why last week, well, this week sucked for videos, and somebody else's channel who needs some love. So I guess we'll talk about him first. So I saw yesterday on Twitter that the Flaming Shark, his channel got taken down, and I, as well as anybody, knows how frustrating that can be, how just heartbreaking that can be. And I saw that on Twitter. I've subscribed to him. I don't subscribe to a lot of YouTubers who are reaction video makers. I really don't. And no offense, Cobra, no offense, anybody else who knows me, who is in the reaction community. It's not that I don't like your content. It's just that if I left reaction videos because I didn't like making them, I don't really think I would subscribe to a channel that does reaction videos if I don't like making reaction videos. But I did subscribe to the Flaming Shark because he, of all the YouTubers who did reaction videos on anime, seemed to sort of be the most sort of growing, the biggest growing YouTube channel in the community. And I figured I'd throw my support there because if he's going to be blowing up like that in this community, I figured I might as well show my support. And yeah, so his channel got terminated, and so he's fighting it at the moment. I extended my condolences and a hand out on Twitter and said, if you ever need anything, just let me know. And that offer still stands. So Flaming Shark, if you're watching, hey, I would love to help you out in any way that I can. If I can't help in any way, I'd love to collab when you get your channel back, or if you have to make another one, and we can reminisce on the shit that YouTube does to take people down. And I really do hope that things go well for you. I'm here for you, man. I get it. This is my fourth channel, so though I've never gone as far as you have, so I really hope you get your channel back for all that time and effort you've put into it. If you guys want, head on over to his Twitter and send him some love. That would be awesome. I just wanted to extend my condolences to him and make you guys aware of it for those of you who don't know. So just wanted to throw that out there. Now, talking about my channel for a minute and what's been going on, obviously I didn't post a lot of videos this week because, well, this week has been rather stressful. Not so much because of what's been going on with my chair's squeaky. I should probably get a stool that isn't squeaky at some point. But it's been very stressful, not because of what's been going on, the thing that I cannot name, otherwise the video will get demonetized, but more in the sense that I have been hyper aware of what's going on because it's in the news every single day, as it should be, because it is something worth concern. But it's been more stressful because obviously I want to continue to make content and I want to continue to remain healthy to make this content. And I've been obviously working in a retail environment for many, many years, and I've gotten a pretty high stress tolerance. I can handle quite a bit of stress. In fact, there are things that customers do, and someday I will do a fireside chat just telling stories of the retail stuff that I have dealt with. That day is not today, but I will tell stories at some point when retail is no longer my employment. But there is, to some degree, this sort of sick reveling that I have when customers get rowdy or are jerks. I love that kind of stuff. I revel in hate. But here's the problem. When this thing that's going on in the world is all we're hearing about, and on top of that, I have to both manage that in my stress and manage the fact that while we're being told to socially distance ourselves, if you don't feel good, quarantine yourself, like that kind of stuff, the fact that all of that is going on and I'm still working full shift days, which I have no problem with, I'll go out and work, whatever, but the fact that I'm working those full shift days while also dealing with people who are coming out and complaining that we don't have products because they came out right as the shit hit the fan, and they're complaining that we don't have things to help them work from home or freeze their food or whatever the case may be. Because of that, I have literally been stressed beyond belief, and when I come home in the evening, and I would normally come home with no problems, just come home, sit down, edit, whatever, I come home, I kind of sit on the couch and wake up at like 1 in the morning because I fell asleep on the couch because I'm just so exhausted. So I'm not using that as an excuse. I should manage my time better, or I should make time to put videos ahead so that they're scheduled to be posted, but shit happens. And so because of that, this week was really bad. I have some plans for today, tomorrow, and I definitely have some plans for both Monday and onward, because where I work has finally begun to limit scheduled times. We've unfortunately been deemed as a necessity for a lot of people, despite the fact that we're not stocked with anything. So like, we're a necessity, but the necessities that people need to buy from us aren't there anymore, so that kind of sucks. But yeah, so my schedule, I'll have a consistent time off in the evening that I can make videos. So hopefully that won't be as big of an issue as it has been for this week. As for what this week is going to be for the rest of this week, I'm going to be making a sort of impromptu video about something Apple recently did with their iPads, literally did yesterday with their iPads, which was kind of surprising. So I'm going to be talking about that today. And Friday is going to be a live stream. I'm going to put that up as a prepped thing for what we'll be doing. And that'll give me a chance for basically all of Friday to record things, because I don't have to post anything, I just have to live stream, which I can do just fine. I'm not going to say what the live stream is going to be yet, I want it to be a surprise, but yeah, so essentially, that's what we're going to do. Next Monday is obviously going to be My Hero Academia, which I'm super excited for, as I am with every episode of My Hero Academia, but I'm definitely excited for this one because it's sort of the big culmination of everything that everybody wanted to do for this series, so we'll see what happens. On Tuesday, I'm planning for a unscripted review. Depending on how far I can get, I'm going to be either doing Black Clover, if I can get far enough in to justify a review, or if I can't get that far and I don't think I can justify a review for that, I'll be doing Konosuba. So one of the two. Either way, you'll have an unscripted review for Tuesday. And Wednesday, we'll see. I've got a couple ideas kind of floating around. Thursday's going to be another tech video. And then, of course, Friday will be a funny Friday. That's about it. I just wanted to get this out and let you guys know what's going on. And obviously, like I said, I want to stay as healthy as possible to continue working on this channel. And the stress that I have been under to go into work and deal with people, it's not the going into work that stresses me out. I love what I do. It's the working with people who seem 100% oblivious about how bad what's going on can potentially be and already is. That stresses me out, because then at that point, every time I deal with somebody, they're just like, oh, this thing's not a big deal. Put her there. Thanks for selling me something. And I won't shake their hand, and then they get frustrated with me. And then even just dealing with them at that distance, I go and just wash and sanitize my hands. Like, that's the kind of stress that I've been under. So I don't want to like make it seem like it's really a big deal, because it's not. I can handle myself just fine. But so I'll be putting all of that effort I've been putting into just sort of avoiding people, I'll be putting that into videos now that I have a couple days off to do that. So just putting that out there. Either way, guys, thank you very much for watching this update, for those of you who did. And just stay healthy out there. I know that I have a fairly wide-reaching viewership, so I know I've got people from Japan, the UK, here in the States, like all over the place. And I really hope that you guys are doing okay. Wash your hands, keep yourself healthy, go send some love to freaking Flaming Shark, because he could use it right now. Because if you've never worked hard to build a channel and then have that all taken away, the feeling of that is just the worst. So go show some love, express to him that you may not understand how he feels, but you feel for him. And believe me, just that little bit of help, I know for me, means the world. Hopefully it's the same way for him. Either way, guys, thanks for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe. Check out the links in the description. I still have shirts, not this one. This is actually a really cool shirt sent to me by a fan, but normally I wear my own merch because I'm a complete shill like that. But yeah, check out the shirts, and that's about it. Thanks, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Make sure to be there. Please make sure to be there. Have a good one. I have shirts. Please buy a shirt if you want to, or a sweatshirt. I'm getting desperate now. I'm just recording stuff whenever I can at the very end of videos, because I'm starting to do context-specific endings and I'm running out of ideas. So just go buy it, please. Don't be shirtless like Inosuke. If you want to save some, go SFMH. Put that as the code when you go to buy it and save 10%. Please, just, yeah, that's my spiel. See ya.